Welcome back. This is Red Zone in the Lab podcast. This is Deion Deuce Blackman, and this is our continued playoff 2022 NFL playoff series, Super Wildcard weekend coming up. And this is part of the Chiefs game. I got my man Larry Coon over here, diehard Chiefs fan. He ain't somebody that's a Mahomes fan. He been on since we've been in school.
Since 91.
As long as I can remember. What's good with you, man? What you been up to? You hanging tight?
Man, yeah, you know me, man. Just chilling, trying to take care of business, and you know, I'm excited about this this playoff week. I mean, even though the old format, we would have been off, but
I feel it. It's a little more competitive.
The Steelers, though. Okay, we went to two Super Bowls. I got us going back again.
Yeah. All right. So let's before we get there, what made you become a Chiefs fan?
Oh man, it was Tecmo Bowl back in I think it was 90 or 91, Christian Okoye, Nigerian Nightmare, man. I used to love that guy, man.
Yeah.
And then I started watching the game, and I saw how Molly Schottenheimer was running it. I mean, we had an impeccable defense, started off with Derek Thomas and all that.
Yeah,
rest in peace of Derek Thomas. I mean, but other than that, man, we always had running backs. Now we switched it to wide receivers. Because our new coach, Andy Reid, and now we 13 up on the 13 road wins against divisional opponents, and we beat the Broncos. So all you Bronco fans, y'all 13 on the road, you know. But yeah, I mean, I've been just loving them, man. I mean, we were the chef.
Yeah, what was your expectations coming into the season, though?
Not only that,
but I don't know. I kept telling people Mahomes don't work. I said don't panic about Mahomes. So, but did you panic like the beginning of the year, the first eight games? I think y'all came out of there. I think y'all was what?
Three and four.
Then y'all had the bye week. What was your expectations at that point coming out of the bye?
To be honest with you. And I'm a shoot out to the Redskin fan. Man, we gonna win.
Yeah.
You know, I had that type of expectations. Like we can't be stopped. You know what I'm saying? So it was good. We got our running game a little. If you know anything about Andy Reid, he don't run the ball too much. And we got a good quarterback. I mean, a good running back. So. I wasn't too worried, but our defense and Steve Spagnuolo is a good coordinator, defensive coordinator, but I was kind of worried. But they all got it together, made some free some trade, free agency acquisitions, which held us together. And don't give up on Daddy. And don't give up on Dirty Dan. He was a Cowboy fan. He was a Cowboy player. So Dirty Dan Thorne Sorensen, number 49, he's a solid dude.
He's a solid dude.
He come up with it.
Yeah, I mean, he does. He always, it seems like he always has the turning play of the game, right? After giving up so much during the game, at some point, he's going to have a play to make it say, all right, maybe this is why
they put him back. In my book, is the GOAT, man. In my book, he's the GOAT.
Y'all better not rely on him. I don't think y'all got no threat this week because your boy can't throw the ball 20 yards down the field.
We can't sleep. But he still can't throw the ball 20 yards down the field, man.
I don't care if you sleep on him or not. Ben ain't getting that drink 20, 30 yards down the field. Even though he got all those receivers, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, man. I mean, if it's his last game, he might try to put it out.
Yeah, Matthew, though, man. You better watch out for the landlord, man.
Yeah, Honey Badger is the truth, man. He keeps it a hundred, too. He keeps it a hundred. He a real dude, man. You can tell he keeps it a hundred. So, like, what's your biggest surprise this year? Like, any surprises, like a player, game plan, expectation?
The very sneeze.
Okay. Okay.
Because we traded Breland, and Breland used to get smoked when he was with the Skins. But Breland came up good. He came up big during our playoff, our Super Bowl run.
He with the Cardinals now, right? Didn't he just sign with them?
Minnesota. I don't know. I ain't been watching, but.
They cut him because he had issues up there. He was beefing. He signed with the Cardinals last week. Actually, it was gonna be last, but he caught COVID, so he with the Cardinals.
So he landed good though. We might see him in the playoff. I mean, in the Super Bowl if they make it. Mm-hmm. They gotta beat Green Bay. Shout out to the Green Bay Packers, man.
They sitting at home watching this week. So playoff expectations. So you already said y'all going to the bowl. So who you got y'all facing in the AFC?
In the AFC though, it's a two-headed monster, right? We still gotta beat the only two the playoff teams that's in there that we lost to, we gotta worry about Tennessee, of course. Without Derrick
Henry, the King back though.
Okay, number one then, because I was thinking about Josh Allen,
Diggs,
Bills. Yeah, I was thinking about them. Mm-hmm. So I don't know.
Yeah, he back, King back.
But remember, we beat them with Derrick Henry.
Yeah, I did. Back. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So as long as we Mahomes stay down to what he was doing. Take the check down, didn't go for the big play, and keep our running backs in the game so the safeties have to commit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think for the Titans, if you can control the run defense and make
he's like Michael Jordan. You can't contain him, you can't stop him. Only thing you do is hope he has an off game. A couple plays go our way.
But what I'm saying is put eight and a half in the box. Let Tannehill beat you through the air. Because you can't lose that game knowing Derrick Henry. And then it's the opposite with the Bills, right? Make them run because they don't want to run. So, I think,
if it's a shootout with the Bills, I'm taking us.
Oh, yeah, if y'all shoot out with anybody, I'm taking y'all. Ain't no doubt about that. I mean, y'all got too many weapons.
But the NFC is kind of like defensive orientated. Like it's always been. The NFC was a defense, smash mouth, in your face, run the ball type offense. NFC. Mm-hmm. AFC was always kind of like a fly high, type of offenses. So, but we did beat Green Bay. Okay. And that was minus, Devontae Adams and what's the guy named? Rodgers.
Yeah, I ain't had neither one of them.
Yeah. So.
I'm picking that for the whole show. Okay, so
Green
you
Bay,
got
Green Bay, yeah, Green
Kansas
Bay,
Kansas City,
and Kansas City. Yep.
All right. So this game coming up against the Steelers. Let's do some over and under score. What's your score for that game?
28-17.
Oh, that's John. Nice for I don't know, man. 28-17? Man, I got close. I got 31-13.
I mean, don't never get an underdog no chance to wriggle with. Because if we lax off, then we might be in some trouble. So I'm giving it the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah. All right. So let's go. All right. So mine for that game is 31-13. Mahomes passing yards over under 320.
Under.
Under. Oh,
I'm going to give him about 240, two touches.
Okay. Rushing yards for the Chiefs over under 80. Oh,
Combined,
over under 80. So you got 240 for passing.
Yeah. I'm giving about 120.
I got under.
No. 120, and one of the running backs will run on one end. Mahomes might run one end.
Yeah, that's true. Mahomes might run. Because, you know, Clyde Edwards, he's out. They tried him this week, but he's out. So
I get it.
So, what's his name? Williams?
I mean, we got D. Will. Mm-hmm. D. Will. He might be good, and we got Gore.
Yeah, we got Gore. So y'all got those.
And then the young dude, what's his name? I don't know his name. What's the guy's name? Number one. He did kind of good catching out the backfield or what? I mean, Pat might have three touches going in the air, and then one running.
All right, so let's go. Defensive turnovers over under two.
I'm gonna say probably one, which changed the tempo of the game or keep our tempo.
All right, so you already got y'all in Green Bay Super Bowl, win or lose Chiefs Super Bowl against Green Bay.
This is a tough one. You know me, this is my team. So,
mm-hmm.
36-30 in overtime.
I think that's a good prediction. Because a lot of people forget last year, y'all lost four of y'all linemen, man.
Right, and we got Orlando Brown now.
Y'all lost four of y'all linemen last year for the Super Bowl against that defense. You know what I'm saying? And your man was out there throwing dots, but they wasn't catching him.
He was running for his freaking life.
He was running for his life, man. He was putting them jumps on the money, and they was dropping.
And Tyreek Hill, he's fast, but he still got work on his hands.
Yeah, sometimes he got sucks, but sometimes it's like that. Only dude that I can kind of think of that was that fast, didn't drop nothing, was Deshaun Watson.
Deshaun Watson.
Not Deshaun Watson.
Hopkins?
No.
I'm thinking D.O. I mean, no. Dez Bryant.
No. Dez Bryant wasn't like lightning fast. Deshaun Jackson.
Oh, D-Jack.
Yeah, D-Jack. D-Jack. He's the only, because he played baseball too.
Yeah, but who he playing for now? Hold on. He playing for the Rams now.
No. The Rams let him go. He wasn't getting clocked. So they let him go. So he signed with the Raiders. He with the Raiders now.
We still in the playoffs. It might fuck us over. If we get to, if they pass anything and we in another AFC West conference game.
Mm-hmm.
If Derek Carr, because I believe Derek Carr is going to outduel Joe Burrow.
Yeah.
He's going to outduel him. because he has more experience.
Mm-hmm. And both of them playing with house money because neither one of them is supposed to be there, to be honest. So
yeah.
I think that's going to be a good game. I think that's going to be a good game. I think y'all going to blow Pittsburgh out.
Yeah. But see, then in our bracket, I think it's we got to play Titans. If whoever beat this round plays the Titans. So that's going to be the divisional round.
Because the Titans got the one seed?
Yeah.
So, y'all play the winner of – so, y'all got the winners of the Patriots and the Bills.
Like I said.
And then the Titans got the Raiders or the Bengals.
Okay. Like I said, Josh Allen goes back to Buffalo.
I got New England winning that game. I got them beating Buffalo. On Bill Belichick alone, I got them beating Buffalo. That's how much faith I have in the quarterback. I mean, in the coach.
You see how they beat him? That boy, Mac Jones, only threw like three.
Yeah, but it was like in a blizzard though. They was playing like in the storm.
I understand. Run. Well, come on, man. Have faith in your quarterback, though, man. At least give him 10 passes for 20 yards.
He ain't doing that, man. He ain't built like Brady. He ain't doing that. That's going to be it. I think Belichick going to win that game. And I'm saying Belichick going to win. Not no quarterback, whatever, but Belichick going to win that game.
So you think it's coming to go down to coaching?
Yep. I think it's going to be Belichick.
And that wins. I don't care how good your players are, coaching.
Yep.
And that's a big piece right there.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big piece. When they call the timeout in close games, I get what you're saying, dude.
Yeah. All right, man. Yeah, man. I appreciate you coming on, man. Talking about them Chiefs, because I wonder, you know, where did it come from? Because I mean, man, Chiefs.
I knew it wasn't
because of Mahomes, because you was a Chiefs fan when we was in high school. So I knew it wasn't. I already knew it wasn't Mahomes. I knew that. Other people might not know that don't know you that long.
It was a nightmare.
But I know. I know. Telling people, man, look, I've been a Chiefs fan for over 30 years. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I knew. I already knew. I already knew it wasn't because of Mahomes. But it's good for the people to find out why. Because my cousin here, Broncos fan. So, you know what I'm saying? It's like, Broncos, but Elway was his man. So.
13, like I said, 13
straight,
baby.
I'm just saying. 13 straight. Yep. All right, man. Appreciate you for coming on, man. Hopefully, you know, if you all get out of this weekend, you'll come back on, because I don't know no more Chiefs fans but you.
So. I'm gonna talk more.
All right, appreciate, man. That's my man, Larry Coon, man, representing the Chiefs. This is Red Zone Podcast in the lab.
Why you guys? What look here, man? Just little Larry, man. I'm just little Larry.
Larry.
Everybody know me, man. They know me. How you doing? Surprise! I'm back. Gotta go. All right,
my man, Larry.
Thank you for listening to Red Zone in the Lab Podcast. Please follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Red Zone in the Lab. And you can download our podcast at Spotify, iTunes, and Podbean. And please visit our website at redzoneinthelab.com. Thank you.